Welcome to the Project Relay. My name is Pieter Bots. I'm an associate professor at Delft University of Technology, and I developed the way of working that we call the Project Relay. In this course, you'll have the opportunity to take part in a Project Relay. We call it a relay because, like in athletics, you run part of a race, while other learners do their part. However, a Project Relay is not a race, but a series of hands-on exercises where you have to review and then build on the work of others. In this video, I'll introduce the relay to you. It may seem a little complicated at first, but the relay software that I've developed will guide you through the process, so don't worry. In a Project Relay, you will conduct a number of assignments that follow on from each other. We call each assignment a step in the relay. For this, you will build on a step that has been done by someone else participating in this course. You will not know who this person is. We call this person your predecessor. So, what do you do in each step? The first step is straightforward. You're given an assignment concerning a particular case. You carry it out and then upload your work to the relay system. In each of the following steps, you have to do five things. First, you download the work that has been uploaded by your predecessor, and you see how he or she has carried out the previous steps. Then, second, you review your predecessor's work by providing constructive feedback and rating it on a scale from 1 up to 5 stars. Then, you improve the work, typically by making the changes you have suggested in your review. You then extend the work by carrying out the assignment set for your own step. And finally, you upload this work to the relay system. As you move on to the next step, the system will give your work to other participants in this course. We call this particular participant your successor. Your successor will review your work and extend it by adding the next step. This will continue until all the steps have been done. To get the best learning experience, each step concerns a different case. Let me give you an example. Assume that you start the relay by carrying out the first assignment on biofuels. After uploading your work, you receive work of someone who has done this same assignment, but not on biofuels, but on solar energy. You review this step one on solar energy, improve it, and then build on it by doing the second assignment on solar energy. You then upload your report on steps 1 and 2. As you move on to step 3, the system will give you someone else's report on the second assignment, again on a different topic, for example, electric vehicles. You will review your predecessor's work, now steps 1 and 2, on electric vehicles, improve it, and then build on it by doing the third assignment on electric vehicles still. Once you've uploaded your work, you'll receive a report on steps 1, 2, and 3 by someone else on yet another topic. Review this work, improve it, expand it with assignment 4, and so on. This is repeated until all steps of the relay have been conducted. Now, let me explain how the scoring works. As you work your way through a project relay, you're asked to give a star rating of your predecessor's work. Likewise, your own work is rated by your successors. In each step, the score you accumulate is based on 2 things: the number of stars you receive for this step from your successor, and, secondly, the difference between this rating and the number of stars you gave to your predecessor. This difference is an indication of the improvements you made to the work. This is why this difference is also taken into account. Now, your first inclination could be to give your predecessor a lower rating, so that it's easier for you to get a higher rating from your successor. But beware. If your predecessor feels that he or she has been unfairly rated, he or she can raise an appeal. And if it turns out that you did rate your predecessor unfairly, you will lose points due to the appeal. So, the best way to do well in the relay is to treat your predecessors fairly, provide a constructive review, and see to it that your predecessor really understands why you gave the step the particular score. These 2 principles, fair evaluation of your predecessor and doing your own work well, are the main principles of the relay system. There's more to it, so I advise you to take a good look at the details of the relay system, which you can find in your course documentation. I hope you will appreciate the relay way of working and that you will learn a lot from the course. Good luck!